Hey Libra, welcome to your weekly reading for May 6th to the 13th. I am Charlene Lizette. Let's dive in and see what's going on for you this week. We have the full, or sorry, the new moon happening in Taurus. You are co-ruled by Venus, you and Taurus. And while I don't think you're going to have a direct impact with this new moon unless you have lots of placements in Taurus, I do see that this new moon will create a sort of ripple effect in your life. Yeah. A path forward here on what works and what doesn't. Clarity here on, maybe tempers that flare. And I don't necessarily feel like these are your tempers, Libra. I think they're other people's tempers. And I think you're seeing and recognizing how other people's behavior, other people's needs to be driven by their ego, other people's need to be, in control is really affecting you. And this could be a friendship here that is coming to an end, or maybe a really deep conversation with a friend that makes you realize that somebody in your life is not who they seem. We have death here, and it says, I am learning that endings are merely beginnings. And then we have trine, fluency, ease, talent development, privilege, aptitude, self-comfort. So trine in astrology is a harmonious aspect. It's one of the nicest aspects to have. And so I feel like this trine energy is bringing a sort of ease and an acceptance to the realization that there is somebody in your life who has created a lot of chaos, a lot of pain, a lot of uncertainty, and potentially a lot of financial burdens. And I don't think that this has created poverty for you, but you've just had to be financially responsible for them. And now it's coming to this realization that you can no longer pour your energy into someone who's unwilling to take accountability for their life. It's a very sombering energy, with I remember soul plan, the fated life versus destiny life. I also think, and friendship, I know that a friend is in my life for a reason. I also think that you're realizing that for a long time, you may have felt very indebted to this person. You may have felt very fiscally responsible for this person or emotionally tethered to this person. And with the Tower, the Four of Cups, the Knight of Swords, I think you're like, I'm so done with appeasing you, with walking on eggshells, with having to be at your beck and call or respond and react in a way that works for you. Like at the end of the day here with the Tower, the Four of Cups, and the Knight of Swords, what I'm really seeing is you turning around and unfortunately here making a decision to let it go. To not accept this connection anymore, or to not allow yourself to be dragged into the depths of like the pain, the suffering, the challenges, the sorrow, right? Two of Pentacles here, Five of Swords, Knight of Wands. You're like, this is, you're realizing that a lot of this connection, 333, as I'm saying this, a lot of this connection is based off of ego or the what was interwoven, okay, was based off of ego. And because it was based off of ego, it simply wasn't serving you anymore. And I think for a lot of you, this caused a lot of pain, a lot of heartbreak, a lot of suffering, a lot of challenges. I'm seeing a lot of like arguments or discussions or just like, gaslighters. You know what this is reminding me of as I'm sitting with this energy? You know, people who try and like mix all these things together. So they're like, because you did this, then I have to do that. And you're like, what does one thing have to do with the other? Like, what does this have to do with that? And they try and just muddy the waters and create so much conflict and create so much disruption and chaos that you're unable to see the truth for what it is. And you may have oftentimes found yourself so looped in this like warped chaos that they created. And I think this is a week where you're like, I'm freaking done. I am done with this drama. I am done with this pain. I am done with the problems. I am done with the obstacles. I am done with this feeling here, this feeling of obstacles and challenges and drama and fighting and arguing and words and circular conversations that getting you so confused that you're like, what the hell is going on? We went from here and all of a sudden we're over here, like so toxic, Libra. The fact that you got Vulcan as your amulet tells me that there's going to be some sort of breaking point. The Vulcan amulet is connected to Mount Vesuvius. It's all about passion, fire, vigor. It's very explosive, very sensual, very passionate. When I'm seeing it connected to this reading, what I'm seeing is somebody's had enough. And I think that somebody is you. I think you're like, I'm done here. I have no interest at all in this person, in continuing to engage in this toxicity. Like you're realizing that you are in control of your destiny, and this means that you no longer are going to attach to the outcomes or to their responses or to their desire to elicit a negative reaction from you. So let's dive in here with this reading for your love, okay? Engagement, forgiving, and learning and codependency. Yeah, maybe a lot of you have been recognizing that it's time to break up with your relationship here. Your life is ascending to a higher level of commitment. The Page of Wands, yeah. Forgiving and learning. The Two of Wands, that was a Ten of Cups, and the Three of Pentacles. I'm not going to take it though. And codependency. Maybe for some of you, there's even this realization that the romantic partners you attract never get to that next level because they're connected to passion, love, sensuality, and chemistry, but they don't have the other pillars of stability that are required. So the five pillars of love are as follows: physical attraction, emotional, mental, spiritual, and financial. And you have to have compatibility in these five pillars in order for a relationship to work out and go the distance. And if there's no compatibility in these five pillars, what you will find is that sooner or later the relationship will come to an end. You will find obstacles and challenges and difficulties because there's simply a lack of alignment. There's a lack of compatibility. Oftentimes, we focus so much on the physical, right? Is there chemistry? Are we sexually attracted to each other? Are they emotionally filling my needs, physically, right? However, there's like truly no mental connection. The financial connections, like on two different spectrums. Spiritually, there's no alignment. And so, these relationships, while they can stay connected through either the codependency and the physical, eventually, sooner or later, they come to their demise. And I think what you're realizing here is that the 80-20 rule applies, right? If this relationship is only good 20% of the time, but really crappy 80% of the time, then it's time to make a decision, make a conscious choice here as to whether or not you should stick around or continue to allow this person to be a part of your life. It's a very serious matter here this week. One maybe that you knew needed to come. And with the new moon in Taurus, I think it's a realization that you have these new chapters opening up for you, but you got to let go of the baggage from the past in order to create a space for these new chapters. I'm going to pop this video here to help you out with this connection. If you want to book a session with me, work with me in any capacity, follow my mailing list or my Instagram. It's all in the description box below. Thank you so much for your likes, your comments, your shares, your subscribes. We will see you later, alligators. Peace out. Bye.